Hey, what's up, guys? How are you? Today is finally the day that Justice League has come out, and right now it's time for
Justice!
So I've been waiting almost my entire life for this movie. Like, I've been so into superheroes since I've been a really little kid, like literally 3 years old. I had like Batman and Superman stuff already. So once Marvel started pumping out movies, I knew DC was obviously going to start. So I've been waiting for Justice League for quite a long time. Now I know this movie is one of the most weird productions in history, I would say. Like, there's two directors and like all this stuff has happened. There's talks of contracts and all these other things are happening behind the scenes. So it's actually pretty amazing that this movie actually happened. So this movie technically has two directors. So the first one being Zack Snyder, which he had to leave. And then there's also Joss Whedon, which if you guys know, he actually directed The Avengers, which is one of my favorite Marvel movies. And once again, DC has had a pretty mixed reaction to this movie. Like after Wonder Woman getting like a 92 or 93 on Rotten Tomatoes, I'm pretty sure this movie sits around like a 40 to 45 range. I'm not 100% sure. But let's go see my opinion on this movie. So basically, the movie is all about Bruce Wayne and Diana, aka Wonder Woman, putting together a team to go fight Steppenwolf, which he is basically a giant guy, big bad guy, accomplice of Darkseid, and he's trying to collect the three mother boxes on Atlantis, Themyscira, and Earth. So that's pretty much the plot. Like, you have this bad guy trying to collect all these things to... I'm actually not 100% sure. I'm pretty sure he was trying to get back to Apocalypse where Darkseid is because I'm pretty sure he was exiled or something. They weren't too clear on that, but I'm pretty sure that's what the objective was for him. So yeah, that was kind of a quick little taste of what the plot was. And now let's actually talk about each character individually because there were a lot of characters in this movie. So the first one, obviously, I'm going to talk about Batman, my favorite superhero of all time. Obviously, Ben Affleck absolutely killed it as usual as Batman and Bruce Wayne. Gal Gadot as Wonder Woman was really good too. The exact same Wonder Woman as you've seen in the other movies, so nothing to complain about from her perspective. She had this very, very cool scene. Like, when I saw this scene on screen, I was literally smiling in my chair. It was really, really cool. It's in the bank robbery scene. I know you guys have seen it in the trailer. She stops a bunch of bullets, but she actually, like, runs really, really fast and kind of goes, like, and blocks them all, which was really, really cool to see in IMAX. Next, let's talk about The Flash by Ezra Miller. You can kind of expect him to be pretty similar to Grant Gustin's Flash on TV, which I don't mind at all because I do like Barry being like a funny guy, but I really liked Ezra Miller. I think he was actually funnier than Grant Gustin, which was really cool because him and Aquaman were kind of like the comedic relief in the movie. Next up was Aquaman. I loved him. I love what they did with the character. I love how they didn't make him that cheesy, like, orange and green wearing superhero. They made him, in my opinion, almost like a rock star, like an 80s rock star, like drinks a lot, tattoos, long hair. He was really, really cool, really interesting. It was really cool to see him swimming in the water and everything and interacting with Mira. Jason Momoa just did a great job as him, and I loved what they did to kind of change the character from the comics. Next is Cyborg. He didn't have too many scenes, I would say. Like, he's kind of just on the down low after his accident. He doesn't really want to talk to anyone, but he eventually joins the team, obviously, and helps them out, but he doesn't really have that many scenes. Like, he's kind of just there to, like, do things that involve interactions with, like, technology. He didn't really have that many deep scenes in the movie, which was a little disappointing, but I guess it's kind of hard to introduce Cyborg and make people care about him all in, like, one movie, especially because of how deep you have to go because of all the mechanical stuff in him, and, like, it's a little hard to differentiate between the mechanical side and human side, but I think they could have done that a little bit better. And Superman! Is he alive or not? You gotta watch the movie to find out, because it's technically a spoiler, I guess, if I say it, even though you probably know the answer. And the final character I'm going to talk about, which had a big presence in the movie, is the bad guy of Steppenwolf. So in the movie, he's actually Darkseid's nephew instead of being his uncle like he is in the comics, which don't care about that change at all. And he's been getting a lot of backlash. Like, I'm not really sure what they expected from him. In my opinion, he was actually pretty decent. Like, I wouldn't say he's the worst villain of all time. I wouldn't say he's the best or anything, but I'd say he's fine. He's fine. He's not anything crazy. Like, don't expect some, like, Joker from the Dark Knight kind of stuff or anything. He's basically this giant, like, 10-plus foot monster, CGI monster, with a big pointy helmet and a big axe. And, yeah, that's pretty much it. But he actually does stuff that a bad guy would do. Like, he kills people, he destroys stuff, blows things up, whatever. A lot of movies, in my opinion, like superhero movies, the bad guys don't even really do anything that bad. But Steppenwolf, like, the stuff he did, I was like, wow, okay, like, I want them to take this guy down. So that's why I thought he was an okay villain. The cinematography in this movie was unreal, and you can definitely tell this is Zack Snyder's stuff. The thing about Zack Snyder's directing is I love how he makes the scenes look. Every scene you see, like a fight scene or a big scene, like in that fight on Themyscira, which you guys have seen in the trailer, it's like a flashback almost. Those scenes for Zack Snyder, that is what he does the best. All the scenes, like action scenes that he does, are some of the most memorable stuff I remember about DC movies directed by him. Now, the story, on the other hand, I don't think he's as good at, and that's why I think Joss Whedon kind of like tamed the story a bit, because it was still a little hard to follow even with Joss Whedon. So if it was just Zack Snyder, I'm assuming the story would have been even harder to follow. Another thing they added in this movie was comedy, and DC didn't really want to add comedy at first. As you guys probably know, they wanted that like dark and gritty universe that nobody really cared about. So now they're adding jokes, and it's gonna feel a little more like a Marvel movie. I'm not saying I want it to be Marvel movies or anything, I'm just comparing it to something that's similar. So the jokes, most of them worked, I would say. The best ones were definitely Aquaman and Flash. Flash had some really funny stuff in this movie, guys. The tone was also, I wouldn't say totally different, but it was definitely a lot different than Batman vs. Superman. This movie was fun, lighthearted, it knew what it was trying to do, is trying to bring all these characters together in a really fun way, and it was pretty enjoyable, I gotta say. I really like that tone shift. The last thing I'm gonna say about this movie before I get on to the negatives is I really, really liked the characters. The characters were the absolute best part in this movie. The chemistry was really good between all of them. It was really fun to see. And one other thing is this movie was really good at world building. And when I say this, I'm not saying it like how Batman vs. Superman did it, because throughout the movie, they kind of just sprinkled like world building stuff all over it. And that's what made it feel really, really kind of congested with too much stuff. But this one hit it right on the nail. There was a few things throughout the movie which was world building stuff, like DCEU world building, and I really liked that. There were some really cool Easter eggs as well. So now on to the negatives. So the first negative I have with the movie is it was really, really choppy, especially in the first quarter of the movie. It was kind of just like a scene, totally different scene, totally different scene, totally different scene. I understand why they did that, because Warner Brothers gave them that 2-hour time frame, like it can't be past 2 hours. And I understand, like, it's a little hard to make a really good story with all these characters in less than 2 hours, because honestly, that's really hard to do. Like, I'm just thinking about how I would even attempt that if I was a director, and that just seems like a huge hassle. Another thing was the CGI. Some of the scenes you could definitely tell like it's a green screen and like someone is doing something right in front of it, and I don't know, sometimes it's really noticeable and it's like a little cringy for me as a viewer, but it wasn't too bad. Another issue with CGI I had was definitely with Cyborg. There were some scenes that the robotic part of his face just looked like cartoony almost, which it was only like once in a while, so I can't complain and say like the whole movie Cyborg looked bad or something. The other person was Steppenwolf. There was some scenes where his face looked like really cartoony, like a PS4 game or something. And I don't know, it just took me out. Like, it made me feel like he wasn't legit and not real, like in a live action movie, which in my opinion they should have used a real actor, especially the face, and they could have just made the actor like bigger with the CGI or whatever, but especially the face. I think they could have just cast someone like in the New 52. Steppenwolf is basically just a guy with black facial hair, and I think that would have worked way better than a giant CGI monster. There's also the very first scene in the movie. I was like, what's the point of that? It was like maybe a minute. It was just a quick little recording by a little kid of a character from the Justice League. And the CGI on this character wasn't that great. And honestly, that scene, it was so useless and it took a whole minute. And like, this was the scene to kind of start the movie too. So I was expecting something really cool, really big or funny. And it was kind of meant to be funny, but nobody really laughed. Another thing is that there was no real threat. I know I've seen this in other reviews, and I didn't think it was true until I actually watched the movie. And so this big fight scene at the very end with Steppenwolf and the Justice League, there's only one family that the story kind of followed, and this is where all the parademons are and everything's happening. There's one family in a house, like right here in the middle of a big area, and I honestly didn't even feel scared for them. No parademons went after them. Nothing happened. They were just kind of sitting at home, and I don't know, it just made me feel like there was nothing really at stake. But then it was also revealed that there were more people in this area, but like they weren't shown throughout the movie until like almost the very end. So that part didn't really make that much sense to me. Another disappointing thing was a lot of the funny scenes and overall best scenes in this movie were actually shown in trailers. So one thing that I absolutely hate about trailers is when they add the comedy scenes, because if they add too many, and say, let's say Justice League had 10 comedy scenes, right? So if they show about 5 in the trailers, then people like watch the trailers over and over again, and those funny scenes when you actually see it in the theater just aren't really funny. So some of the scenes, like if I didn't watch the trailers, I would have laughed really hard, but since I had saw them like 4 or 5 times already, I didn't even really laugh. And my final complaint about the movie is there was no black suit Superman. This was the most disappointing thing for me, just because I love that suit. Henry Cavill Instagrammed, I think, the picture of like a zoomed in portion of the suit, so I was expecting it. So when it actually didn't happen in the movie, I was like, what the heck, like where's this suit? I really want to see it. But I guess Joss Whedon must have taken that out last second or something. I feel like the general audience would just be like, why is his suit black or something. It's not really a spoiler because it never happened, so I don't know. Leave a comment below if you really wanted to see that suit or not, because I definitely did. So guys, overall, I thought Justice League was really, really fun. The characters were done really well. The fight scenes were really good. The cinematography was really good. The biggest negatives, I gotta say, is probably the story. Just because they did cut a lot of things out and it felt really choppy. And I know that the extended version, if they have one when the DVD comes out, will definitely be better, because it'll put like 20-25 minutes of story back into this movie. But I gotta judge the movie on what I actually saw at the theater. So it wasn't too bad. It wasn't the greatest movie ever, obviously. So I'm going to give Justice League, the very first Justice League ever made with all these characters on the screen, a B. I really did enjoy this movie, guys. Like, I definitely want to see it again. I definitely want to pick up the steelbook for this. I think I'm gonna get a poster possibly, because that poster looks really, really good. So guys, leave a comment below of what you guys thought about the movie. I thought it was gonna be a little bit better. Well, I was hoping it would be a little bit better, but I knew the movies wouldn't just go from like a 20 something on Rotten Tomatoes to a 90, especially with all these characters and all the problems the movie had just to be made. But this was definitely a step in the right direction. I definitely liked a lot of the changes they made in this movie, and I hope they improve upon it even more and pump out some really good DC movies in the future. So once again, guys, thanks for watching my movie review. If you guys want to see more videos, please leave a comment, a like possibly, or even subscribe, and I'll see you guys next time.